Good morning. I'm great. How are you doing?
Why bike lady? Or how did it start?
Yes, how did it start?
Bike lady really started by accident. My former husband and I had adopted a child after fostering for a number of years, and we wanted to give something back.
Beautiful.
Franklin County Children's Services has this fabulous program called Holiday Wish, and they collect gifts for children under their care. Shortly before the holiday season, my caseworker and I, we were talking about it, and I said, well, what could I do? What's something extra? Not just a Barbie doll, not just a basketball, whatever. What's something just a little extra that you never get at Holiday Wish? We were also talking in that same conversation about all the restrictions that foster parents and foster children must abide by. Can't jump on a trampoline, can't go to a public pool, can't go to an overnight unless the foster parent's going with them. One thing that these kids can do is ride a bike around the block. I got a letter from a 16-year-old girl. Her sister was 13. They had been in foster care since they were, like 4 and 7, something like that. And they'd been in different homes this entire time. And they didn't see each other very often. But there's a bike path, or was a bike path, between the homes that they were placed in. And they were permitted then to ride their bikes. These are two siblings that were able to enrich and maintain their sibling connection and relationship simply because of a bike. So I guess maybe when I'm thinking about why bikes, and yeah, sure, I can't think of basketballs wouldn't be better. I'm certainly not, right? It's that kind of stuff is why bikes.
Jeez. Put your muddy hands in your pockets. Not on me. Put them in your pockets. All right. So.
Ann Fisher.
So Ann Fisher wrote a column in the Columbus Dispatch about what I had done, and Perfect Strangers started sending checks and said, go buy more bikes.
I go back to Walmart for the 7th or 8th time, because every time I get like maybe $500, I go buy more bikes, right? One of the Walmart guys is there and he says, I'm over in the bike aisle and the bike lady's here again. And right there, the bike lady was born. I mean, I hadn't been calling myself the bike lady. Nobody had been calling what I was doing the bike lady or whatever. So from that point forward, every time I went back to Walmart, I'd say, well, the bike lady's here, and everybody knew. You know, the first year that that I did this, and Ann Fisher wrote the column in the Dispatch, and there was a letter to the editor after that column saying, well, why should these kids get a new bike? I mean, that's excessive. Why? Because they're foster children? It's excessive? What these children want is stability, security, a permanent family if they're available for adoption, a healthy family if they're being reunited with their parents, love, and a bike seems pretty darn minuscule compared to what they really want and need. When is enough, bike lady? There's never enough. There's not. There's always another kid. Sadly, there's always another kid. Who is the bike lady? I'm not the bike lady. The bike lady is a group of people that support the mission of creating a positive lifelong memory for children who don't have many positive lifelong memories.